Hello friends, and I'm back with the most awaited topic, that is Article 370. Friend, Article 370 is one of the prominent article which existed in the Constitution of India, particularly in the Part 21, which provides some special and autonomous status to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Constitution is constituted with 25 parts, 448 articles, 12 schedules and more than 100 amendments. In according to 2016 counting, that making a second largest active constitution in the world, friends. And before enter into the history of Article 370 and entire implication, what reason behind, and so let me very clear one thing. Before starting it, there is a term which I am going to use more and more time. And I will be using this word in this video many times, that is instrument of accession. Instrument of accession is a legal document which was executed on 26th October 1947 by Maharaja Hari Singh, who was the rural ruler of princely state Jammu and Kashmir. And other word, I would say this is a kind of treaty which signed between currently Governor General of India, Lord Mountbatten, and King Hari Singh. Friend, if I would talk about the history of Article 370 and what was the purpose, such why we have need such regulation, a special regulation to make prominent such law. So let me tell you, friend, after independence, like all the princely states merging with Indian government, Jammu and Kashmir ruler signed instrument of accession. Originally, accession was on three matter, friends: defense, and foreign affair, and communication. Friend, during the formulation of constitution, all the princely states, including Hyderabad, Jammu and Kashmir, Mysore, Sikkim, Travancore, were invited to send their representative to help and unite India, and they were called at Constituent Assembly, which was founded in 6 December 1946, just before 3 and 4 months before independence 1947. Friend, let me tell you, Constituent Assembly also encouraged to these princely state to set up their own constitution. This was a fundamental, you know, it need to be understood by you guys. As well as Constituent Assembly also told that in May 1949, a meeting had been set up for ruler of princely states and all the chief minister of a state like MP, UP, Punjab, where they said the separate constitution not necessary. We need some kind of constitution, such a constitution for all the states. Therefore, center and state government made unanimously there was something special. And if I talk about the case of Jammu and Kashmir, it was quite different. And later on, accordingly, Article 370 was incorporated into the Constitution of India. And this merging of Article 370 into Constitution of India describe that that the other article of constitution that gives power to the central government would not be applied in Jammu and Kashmir unless the acceptance of its state constituency as a state constituent assembly will be given. Means, unless the moment constituency of state constitutional body will recognize that there could be a kind of application is required to change any kind of formulation, so that will be accepted only. And this was temporary provision, friends, and it was temporary for the period of formulation into the state constitution. And of course, the moment has arrived. However, the state constituent assembly adopted Article 370 on 25th January 1957 without amending any kind of amendment they have done. And thus the article has become a permanent feature. of Indian Constitution, and this confirmation of permanent feature has repeatedly given by the Supreme Court, High Court, many times. And let me tell you, friend, the text into the Article 370, it was temporary provision with respect to the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Provision of Article 238. In our Indian Constitution, there is Article 238, which has their own significance, shall not apply in the relation of state of Jammu and Kashmir. And something is also happened. The power of Parliament to make law for Jammu and Kashmir will be very limited. That has make a close hand to the government. And what the clause 7 of instrument of accession says, that this declares something, this clause declares something, that a state could not be compelled to accept any future constitution. Means the constitution which has been adopted by Jammu and Kashmir will not compelled with any kind of future constitution. The state has right to draft its own constitution. Let me also tell you, friends, Jammu and Kashmir has right to draft, to amend their own constitution and decide itself their additional power. Article 370 was designed actually to protect the right of Jammu and Kashmir people. And what is the thing which makes also very crucial to this constitution, to this article, that is neither center or state can abrogate or amend this article. No one has power. Friend, now I am going to tell you the six special provision which has been prescribed in this Article 370. Firstly, a state is allowed to have its own constitution. And friend, this constitution, like our Indian constitution, is start from "We the people of India having solemnly." So this is also start from "We the people of Jammu and Kashmir," and this is goes on. And secondly, the special provision is central government power will be limited on defense, foreign affairs and communications. These are the three areas where the central government power will be limited. And thirdly, central government constitutional power will be accepted and extended unless the state legislative assembly will pass that power, that kind of amendment. Otherwise, no chance that any kind of power will be accepted of our central government. And all the provision lies on its legislative assembly. Legislative assembly of the state has much power than the central government. Fifth is once a state legislative assembly finalize any kind of a scheme, therefore no other amendment will be accepted whether it is central government, state government, no possibility to have it. And sixth special provision is that is very very important to understand. Article 370 will be abrogated or amended only the recommendation of legislative assembly of the state, otherwise it cannot be possible. And let me tell you, friends, the all-time criticism which is going on television, and this was the always had a topic, had a headache for the entire country people. Some of us repeatedly saying that the moment Article 370 get removed, terrorism will be stopped, and also saying that this removal of 370 bring new job opportunity, business opportunity within the state that can only controlled by providing some kind of job to the people who are actually literate or not, they have education, but some kind of they need opportunity. And but personally, if you ask the question to me personally, I think Jammu and Kashmir has known for its beauty, it's a natural beauty, and Article 370 is strengthening this beauty from all kind of industrializations. And if any kind of requirement is required for interest of the people of the India, that will be accepted by center or any kind of legislative assembly at any rate. I hope everybody would agree with me out here. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much.